I think Kerala's politics has reached a point where the current left government is being repeatedly exposed for its complicity in corruption, in land encroachment. And I have been raising these issues quite strongly, and it is quite clear that media affiliates associated with me have also been exposing these kinds of corruption. So when political frustration reaches a level, I think political leaders start doing stupid things and start resorting to stupid acts. So using vandalism, using violence, using intimidation is something that the left used to practice many years ago, continues to practice, and they've tried that in the last 2 days. But it will fail. Intimidation doesn't work well with me. And I don't scare very easily, not of Pinarayi Vijayan, nor of his DYFI goons. There were this is the irony, or this is the sad part of what has happened, that today in a civilized democracy like ours, where we boast of our democracy, that a government, a duly elected government,
yes,
instead of using the due process of law, uses 100 hooligans, 100 gundas, to assault one of the largest private investments into the state.